EU election observation mission assesses an electoral process. After invitations from the government and the election commission of Nepal, the mission arrived on 25th of October last year, and we returned to Europe on 3rd of January. The mission was the largest international observation mission in Nepal, issued its preliminary assessment on 9th of December. Both our preliminary assessment of the elections and this final report are based on regional and international commitments to which Nepal has signed up to, as well as the laws of Nepal. Now, if I may offer some remarks on our overall assessments of the elections as detailed in our final report. Overall, the elections represented a key milestone in the implementation of the 2015 Constitution, with a legal framework providing a good basis for the conduct of elections. However, a great deal of the body of electoral law was enacted less than 3 months before the elections, which meant that there was insufficient time for dissemination of or appraisal. Political freedoms, including the right to vote and to stand for election, and freedoms of association, assembly, and expression, are well respected in law, and despite a series of violent attacks against candidates, these political freedoms prevailed during the campaign. The quota systems, in an effort to promote gender and social inclusion, also includes groups that are already well represented. This is arguably in contravention of international standards on equality, as affirmative action measures are foreseen only as a means to promote equality. Although the Election Commission of Nepal performed its duties impartially, its works lacked transparency. For example, there was no mechanism for regular consultations with election stakeholders, and the Election Commission failed to publish critical information on polling center turnout, and invalid votes. There were also procedural weaknesses, particularly in relation to the reconciliation of ballots. Voter education was also inadequate, in some areas non-existent. The Election Commission had extensive powers to punish violation of the Election Code of Conduct, including by fines and disqualification, yet it dealt with complaints in a largely informal manner. This lack of enforcement undermined the integrity of the code. Allegations that both cash and in-kind gifts were given to the voters circulated wildly, but not a single prosecution for vote buying was initiated. Positively, a voter registration drive resulted in 1,370,000 new registrants. The candidate nomination process was well conducted, and the media environment during the campaign period was generally free, although a few cases of limitations on freedom of expression and the freedom of press were observed. And now we are coming to recommendations. I'll conclude now with recommendations that come from our overall assessments of the 2017 elections. Let me repeat again what I said earlier. These are recommendations for your consideration, deliberation, and reflection. We are not telling you what to do. They are offered constructively as a way of improving the electoral process for future elections. And we strongly believe that if implemented, they would meaningfully contribute to Nepal's democratic environment development. There are 29 recommendations, all listed in an annex at the back of the report, as well as detailed in the body of the report. They cover the legal framework, the election administration, voter registration, voter education, election day, the result process, complaints and appeals, and the media. On pages 7 and 8 of the report, we list 10 priority recommendations which should ideally be considered as early as possible, in order to address the shortcomings in the 2017 election.